There are many other type of the functions, including the previously discussed functions, in which we have discussed many of the functions in previous two lectures. However, let's discuss some more functions. These are commonly used, linear function, a function of this form mx plus b, where the power or degree of x should be 1. That's known as linear function. If in linear function b equal to 0 and m equal to 1, if m equal to 1 and b equal to 0, this becomes identity function, means f of x equal to x. Okay, whatever value of the domain, that will be the value of the range, means same value we obtained whatever we substitute in it. That's known as identity function. Identity function has the graph same value on both. If one value here, the one value will be on y-axis. If one value, minus one value, we put as a domain on x-axis, we will get a minus one value here. So its function will always be a straight line, but like this. Its identity function f of x equal to x. Okay, and a constant function is a function when m equal to 0. When this m equal to 0, this becomes a constant function. In constant function, we have y equal to b, any value. Okay, or we say f of x equal to b. Okay, that's known as constant function. In constant function, we will have same value on y-axis for different values on x-axis. Okay, whatever value we substitute as a domain, as a value of domain, we will get the same value, this b. Okay, whether it is from the positive side, positive value of the y, or negative value of y. Suppose here it is, value is 2, b equal to 2, it continues 2. Whatever value we substitute as a x in x, 1, 2, 3, we substitute as a domain, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Okay, it's a constant function, same line, here will be a horizontal line for this constant function when f of x equal to b. Okay, there are two functions which are mostly confused, power function and exponential function. There is difference between these two functions. A power function is a function in which power is a constant, but base is itself a domain value. And exponential function is a function in which the base is a constant value, but the power is itself a independent variable x. The some example of the constant functions are itself x, x square, x cube, x fourth, x power 5. These are power functions. And exponential functions we know well, 2 power x, e power x, these are exponential functions. These type of the functions are known as exponential function. Exponential function have the domain minus infinity to infinity, but we always get value, means codomain. Codomain we always get, or we say its range is always 0 to infinity. We never get 0 in exponential function, so we never assume for the 0 as value of the exponential function. We have some values for greater values than 0, means all positive values we get from the exponential function. Okay, and power function has graphs. These graphs are well known. Okay, the graph of x square you know well in this way, and graph of x cube, okay, graph of x cube, x fourth will be some wider than this x square. It is graph of x fourth, similarly graph of x fifth. Okay, in this way there are the graph of each and every function. The graph of power function when x is even will be symmetric to the y-axis, and when it is odd, it will be symmetric to the origin. Okay, so exponential function have the graph like this. Okay, the well-known graph of the E, that say exponential functions are symmetric to the x-axis. Okay, symmetric. They are symmetric to the x-axis. It may be symmetric to the x-axis. It may be symmetric to the y-axis. And polynomial functions or the functions in which the power of x should be positive integers, means from 0 to any positive number, these should be integers. Integer means these should not be fractions or decimal numbers. Okay, polynomials have from 0 to any positive power. These are the coefficients of the polynomials. Okay, polynomials may be quadratic or cubic. Okay, so from the polynomial we have the functions, quadratic function. Okay, you know well that the quadratic function is well known, ax square plus bx plus c, that's quadratic function. And we also have cubic function when the degree of the x is 3. Here degree of x is 2, so that's quadratic function. When degree of x is 3, that's known as cubic function. Okay, rational functions are the algebraic functions. These when we have p of x and a q of x, means in fraction form, we also call them quotient. As a quotient, we write the rational functions, and they are polynomials themselves. Okay, as a numerator and denominator, but this qx should not be equal to 0. That's the condition of the rational function. And algebraic functions are the functions which are made from the polynomials using addition, division, multiplication, subtraction, etc. These are known as algebraic functions. Okay, and trigonometric functions are the function in which we have the trigonometry are used, trigonometric ratios are used. That's cos x, sin x are their powers and their sums, their multiplication. These are known as trigonometric functions. Okay, for example, here we have cos x, cos square x, cos x into sin x. These all functions are known as trigonometric functions. Okay, there are many other types of the functions. We have sine function. There are many other type of functions which can be discussed. Okay, when we have a sine function in which we have positive value, negative value or zero. Okay, from the right side we have positive values, and from the left side we have negative values and a zero here. When x is greater than zero, we always get negative value, positive value. We get a positive value of the function. When the value of x is less than zero, we always get a negative one. And when it is zero itself, we get a value zero. That's known as sine function. Okay, in sine function we get 1 when positive value of x, we get negative 1 for the minus values of x, and we get 0 when we have 0 itself.